everyone. Welcome back. In this section of this tan stand design, we are going to be considering transferring this structure to Prota Steel and focus on base plate and anchor bolt design. So stay tuned. If you are not in the previous last three lessons, you should check the video right there on my channel so you can follow it appropriately. Let's get straight away into the lesson. I want to also bring to our knowledge that this structure has been analyzed and designed. Before you should transfer your structure to Prota Steel, you should ensure that you carry out analysis successfully of each of these structural elements. And we have done that successfully in the last two lessons. So to take this structure to Prota Steel, I will navigate to the drawing and report tab right there. And I can see there under steel detailing tab, you see Prota Steel right there. So what I just need to do is just have to click on it. So once I click on it, I will give the program some seconds to actually launch the Prota Steel automatically as it is in progress. I will need to close this notepad. This shows that all the profile has been imported successfully. So just have to close that. And if I zoom it closely, this is the structure transferred to Prota Steel. I can orbit it this way, right? So our aim is to focus on base plate and anchor bolt connections. So for me to do that successfully, I want to hide some of these structural elements, the columns. So if I highlight all of these columns just like this, I can just right click and then click on hide selected, and all the columns will be hidden as in the concrete columns. All right, so I will rotate this way and I will do closely. So for me to insert a base plate here, we have two type of base plate in Prota Steel: the base plate with movement and the one without movement. The one with movement consists of stiffeners. Alright, and so we'll be demonstrating how to actually implement the two successfully. Okay, so considering the first one, I will just have to navigate to the tools provision and then I'll click on this more button arrow sign, then bring my hand down. This is the first base plate, this one, and you can see the second one there. So for you to place it, click on it, left click to select that, then click on the column to actually insert the base plate just like this. So you can also click on this to also insert it, but you can see an error message there. The section type of column is not supported. The reason is because this column consists of movement at the end, at this end point. Okay, so it is that of the stiffener that is suitable for these provisions. But if you keep trying to place this one, it will be applied successfully. But the program will prompt you, warning you that there is a movement here, you should use the base plate with stiffener. So if I should try it again, I'll come to the provision, I click and then I select the columns again. You can see it's inserted successfully. All right, so if I placed on this one, it's still wanting to, because there's a movement at the end of this column transferring the twisting forces to the foundation, and so it's giving me warning. So I will need to try it again to place that and it will accept the base plate. But if I should try to use the base plate with stiffener, let's see how that works. I will come to this provisions, click right there, and then I will select this one, then select the column. You can see it's inserted. But one thing you will observe in this one is there is a clash stiffener between this beam, this one. So you can leave this stiffeners so as to have a clear distance to avoid that clash, just like this. So after you do that, you must have done that, you can see there is no more clash, okay? Alright, so this is how to place this base plate. So I want to continue to place it successfully in the remaining two stanchions. So I will click on this one and select this. It's giving me warning. I will try it again. I'll select the columns. I will still try it again. It's still giving me warning. Alright. So I will try it on the other columns. The same thing, because there's a movement in that provision. The same thing. But if I should use this instantly, it will instruct it successfully. Because it is the right base plate for that. You can see it works effectively just like that. Okay, so having added the base plate successfully, to now place the anchor bolt, what I just need to do is I will come to this provision. You can see anchor bolt right there. I will left click on it, right click, and select the base plate to insert it in the host provisions. Okay, and I will do the same to other base plate to actually insert my anchor bolt successfully, just like that. I'm having four of it in these provisions, you can see. Alright, so I have successfully added my anchor bolt and as well as the base plate. So if you want to edit this anchor bolt, like you want to change the directions where it is facing, what you just need to do is you double click on it. Once you double click on it, you have the anchor bolt property dialog. In this property dialog, you can go to geometry. In the geometry, you can see the both the anchor bolt and its parameter. The depth, the length of the anchor bolt, you can see the name as well as the diameter, the materials and the capacities as well. Okay, so if you want to turn it either way, all right this is the rotation. So you just make provisions right here, 180, and then click on apply. It has turned to this other way, you can see. All right so if you want to adjust the hook angles as well as the radius of the curve, you can see the provisions there, after which click on OK. So we have successfully placed the anchor bolt. For this one, if I want to be returning it inside, okay, I just have to double click on this one and then I input 180 just to turn it this other way around. Okay, I click on apply. That is it. So I click on OK. So having played this anchor bolt successfully, I want to enable the heating reinforced concrete columns foundations. For me to do that, I will right click and then click on show all, and you can see all the concrete columns is visible now. So you can see this anchor bolt trying to come out of the concrete, so I can just double click on that and then change the directions so that it can be modeled enough. Okay, click on apply, just like that. Click on OK. Likewise to this other ones that is coming up out of the columns, it can be also adjusted successfully. Click on OK, just like that. The same thing applicable to this 180. And this last one, do the same thing, double click right there, input 180. OK. and then apply it. And okay, so if I should orbit this, you can see how modern it is. So we have successfully used and extracted two type of base plate. If you zoom closely, this is how it looks. Okay, the station has already been welded. This is one of our welding signs to the base plate. For the thickness of the base plate can be adjusted. Select the base plate, double click on that, and you can see the thickness of it is 30. All of this can be adjusted successfully. Come to the general, you can see the material. Okay, and it is, the discipline is concrete, as you can see. All right, and then the embedded steel member is also there. Okay, if you also click on this one, if you also show the thickness, it can be edited successfully. But Prota did one good thing about Prota steel. One good thing about Prota steel is you doesn't need to make provision for the size, as to adjust the size of the base plate before you placed it. It will create an appropriate size for the base plate based on the forces that are coming at that particular point on the steel. So Prota structure will calculate that for you successfully. I want to bring the lesson to a stop here, as we are going to continue, as we shall be considering other connections. For the connections of the base plate and the anchor bolt, we have done that successfully. So stay tuned for more advanced lesson, as we shall proceed in the next lesson. See you right there. Subscribe. Like the lesson. I'm suffering. Bye for now.